Hello, this is Ross Plaskow, and welcome to my first tutorial, How to Make a Cartoon for Beginners. Here's what we're going to be making today. Oh hey, I'm Ross, I've just run out of ideas, so I'm going to make a fucking tutorial. It's very simple, you have a body, arms, legs, eyes, and mouth. File, new, 1500 by 1500. It's best to be too big than too small, otherwise it might pixelate if you ever zoom in. Get rid of this white background. This button is called the new layer button, click that. Okay, now you can delete the white layer. Okay, so B to use the brush tool over here, change the color. Okay, body, there's a body. Obviously you're going to spend a lot more time on this than I'm going to spend in this tutorial because I've already made one. The body, new layer. I'm going to make an eye, black left eye. Let's label this left eye like a motherfucker. New layer, right eye, like a subsequent motherfucker. Always label once you've drawn it, okay? New layer, right click, and you can change the size. Bigger, smaller, whatever. The mouth, it's going to be a flat line. That's not a flat line, Ctrl Z, undo. Flat line, there you go. Mouth, this is just a guide because the mouth we're going to use later will actually be a selection of real mouths that you can change along with the audio. Left arm, there's an arm, I'll call that an arm. Someone text me. New layer, right arm, classic right arm, relabel that right arm, well our arm, doesn't really matter. It absolutely doesn't matter in this because I already have one already made. The same with left leg. New layer, label it left leg, draw the left leg. Now this is where it gets interesting. As you can see that the left leg is above the body. What we're going to do is we're going to drag the layer underneath the body. There you go. Here's another interesting thing. If you want to duplicate the leg, Ctrl J. There you go. You can move that shit around. You can move it around. And then relabel that left leg copy right leg, because it's now a right leg. Can you see where I'm going with this? Can you see that this is a rough version of this? Can you see this? Can you see it? You can see it, can't you? You bastard. Okay, now we're going to extend the body. We're going to press B for brush, and we're going to sample the color by holding down Alt and then clicking. There you go, change the size, like I said earlier. And we're going to put in a bloody tail, a rubbly bloody tail. Here we go. You can see where I'm going with this. I'm going to add in some spikes. New layer. Call it spikes. Why don't you? Spikes are usually underneath the body. B again for the brush. Darker. Make it darker than the body. Draw in some spikes. There you go. You got a bloody character. Maybe put in a belly in there. New layer. Belly. Make it white. Or light pink or whatever. There you go. Now, you can spend a lot more time on this refining it and making it a little bit nicer looking like this. A shadow could be a nice idea. Is exactly what you've just seen me do. New layer. Shadow. Draw a black shadow. Make it look nice, obviously. Use some, you know, opacity down. There's a shadow. Okay, now what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to crop by pressing C. Crop this so that the file is a little bit smaller. Now you have a layered character. Look at that. You're one step closer to being an animator. Just kidding. No, you're not. Yes, you are. I was just kidding. File, save as a PSD. You save it as whatever you want. I'll save mine as dinosaur, except my dinosaur's already finished. I don't need this bullshit. Here we go, I've got my finished thing. All layered up and ready to be taken into After Effects, except for one bloody thing. Mouths. Here's some mouths I made earlier. Quite a small composition. You're gonna need 8 different types of mouths. You're gonna need an F, a S, or a Sh, T. You're going to need a L, E, ah, oo, M, and M. In case you're wondering how to solo a layer, hold down Alt and click on the eye of the layer. There you go. You like that, don't you? Okay, so we have After Effects open. We have our dinosaur character layered up and ready to be animated. We have our 8 mouths as a separate PSD all layered up and ready to be animated. And we have our audio file. Now, let's import them one by one into After Effects. Here is the audio. Double click over here in the project file to import something. The dinosaur, open. Composition, okay. Double click over here. Mouths, open. Composition, okay. Now we're going to be animating inside the dinosaur composition because that is where the dinosaur is. We're going to change the size of the composition. Composition settings. Change the size of it so that we have more space for him to run around, or he's not actually going to be running around, he's going to be leaning forward and backwards and talking. Change the background color so you can see him a little bit better. Press OK, press OK, get rid of these weird guides. I don't know why they keep popping up, but I want to delete them, but I can't be bothered to right now. So everything is going to be attached to this body layer because the body is going to be basically rotating forwards and backwards so that the dinosaur can lean forwards and backwards. The body and everything else has this thing called an anchor point. Because it's from the same PSD file, they all have exactly the same anchor point, which means when you rotate it, R to rotate, it will rotate round that anchor point. We don't want that. We want to change the anchor point. Press Y, drag the anchor point down here, so that the body rotates from the hips. However, nothing is attached to the body yet. What we're going to do is parent all of these layers, except for the legs and shadow, to the body. So highlight all of the layers, pick whip onto the body, and now everything is parented to the body, so that when we rotate the body, everything rotates with it. Now that's done. Change the anchor point of the eye. The left eye anchor point should be in the center of it. The right eye anchor point should be in the center of that. The mouth guide anchor point should be on the mouth. And we take the anchor point for the left arm and put it at the top so that we can press R, rotate it from there. And then the same with the right arm. Control down to select a different layer. Change the anchor point, rotate, and it will rotate from there. That's where the arms are meant to rotate from. Now we are ready to get in the basic movement. And in order to do that, we need the WAV file. Drag it over here. So you can see it's less than 4 seconds long. Let's have a listen. Oh, hey, I'm Ross. I've just run out of ideas, so I'm going to make a fucking tutorial. Okay, so he sounds pretty angry, so... he's probably going to lean back, hit the clock to set a keyframe for the body. Go forward a few frames and lean him back. So he's like, oh, hey,
I'm Ross.
Move the keyframes over. Maybe make it a bit quicker. To shift keyframes, you can hold down Alt and left and right. Highlight the two keyframes for easy ease. F9, that will make it smooth.
Hey, I'm Ross. I've just run out of ideas, so I'm going to make a fucking tutorial.
He'll probably lean forward. Right now I'm scrolling through. You can hear the audio because I'm holding down Ctrl and I'm scrolling through.
I'm going to make a fucking tutorial.
Okay, so now we have him leaning
backwards. Oh, hey, I'm going to make a fucking tutorial.
And then we also have him leaning forwards. Now we're going to animate the eyes looking up. When he leans back, he highlight both eyes, press P for position. Tap the clock at this point so that you have a keyframe at the beginning of when he leans back. Scroll forward to the point where he is leaning back and move the eyes up using the arrow keys. Now he's looking at the ceiling, but you also want to easy ease all of that, so highlight them all and press F9. So now he's leaning back and looking up.
I've just run out of ideas. I'm going to make a fucking tutorial.
At
this point, click the diamond to make another keyframe. Go forward. Oh, that's not in line, is it? So Alt right to shift those keyframes. Go forward, Control right, make another set of keyframes and move those puppies down. There you go.
Oh, tutorial. Oh, hey, I'm Ross. I've run out of ideas, so I'm going to make a fucking tutorial.
There we go. We have the basic movement. Here's another thing to make the animation look a little bit better. We have what is called anticipatory movement. So when you're going to punch someone in the face, you pull back before you punch forward. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to go back about three frames. One, two, three. Press a diamond. Make a keyframe. Go forward here to this one. Now, he's going to go from here to here, which means that he's moving backwards. So we're going to move him forwards 0.3. And that will make it look like he's slightly moved forwards. He's gone from 0 to 0.3 to all the way back. Also, he's going to have a little bit of bounce. So move forward 3 frames, keyframe. Make him go a little bit too far backwards, minus 5.3. And now you can see that he sort of bounces.
Oh, hey, I'm Roth. Oh, hey, I'm Roth. Oh, hey,
probably
I'm Roth.
Can't really see that in the playback. Oh, I can't see it in the playback. Hey, it doesn't look very smooth.
Hey, I'm Roth.
So he's got a little bit of bounce. We're going to do the same thing over here. One, two, three. Before this movement, we're going to... He's going to move forward, so that means we're going to move him too far backwards. 0.3 is a good, subtle number. One, two, three. For the bounce, we're going to make it 9.3 because he moves a bit too far forwards and then bounces back.
Fucking tutorial.
Now we are going to move the arms outwards because he's very emotional. Highlight both the arms. Rotation keyframe there. Go to the end of his movement. Another rotation keyframe there. Easy ease F9. Make the left arm go out. Rotate out, let's say 54, and then this one will be minus 54 or whatever. Whatever looks good. Okay, so now when he leans backwards, he's moved his arms. We're going to go over here. He's going to make another set of keyframes go forwards and just set them both to 0 again so that he moves them back. You see that?
Oh, hey, I'm just run out of ideas. I'm going to make a fucking tutorial.
There we go. This next section is called lip syncing. Now you may notice that all we have here is a mouth guide, and this is why I said that you should make 8 mouths and put them in their own PSD file. What we're going to do is we're going to pull the mouths out, put them over the mouth guide, parent them like we did before with the body, and now they move with the body. But obviously they are all there at the same time and they're a little bit big. S for scale, scale them down to about the size of the actual mouth. Hide the mouth guide, or you can even delete it because now you have a bunch of mouths. And now we are going to go inside this composition of mouths and you'll see all of your different layers that you made in Photoshop. Composition. Background change there. What we're going to do is we're going to change the composition
length
so that we have each mouth on its own frame so that we can select whatever mouth we want by just typing in the frame number. Trust me on this. We're going to go into composition settings, change it to 7 frames, and we're going to highlight them all, press Alt and then the square bracket to make them just one frame long each. V to be able to select them. Drag them so that each of them takes up one frame each. Actually should have made that 8 frames long instead. What a fucking mongoloid. Go back out of this composition to dinosaur. Here's a shortcut. Shift. Left, enter. We're going to right click, time, enable time remapping. Get rid of this keyframe here. It's going to stick with 0 the whole way through. And look, it's stuck on the first mouth. Now we're going to scroll through
holding down Ctrl so that we can hear the audio.
Oh, hey, I'm Ross. I've just run out of ideas.
What we need in the silence is a flat mouth. I'm just going to scroll through. It's number 6. Oh, we need an O sound, so I'm going to make another keyframe of the flat mouth so that the next frame can be something completely different, like that. You got to make them side by side, because otherwise if you say, oh, he's saying S over here, set a S over here, but then in between here and here, there's just a whole... It's just scrolling through all of the other numbers. So what you got to do is you got to go like one by one with these things. So, here he's going to have a woo sound. Woo. Woo. Oh. Oh. And then a huh sounds probably that one. Make another one of them, and A. Another one of them so we can switch to keyframe. Then we need a M. We need a O. That looks about right. 6. No, 4. So it's a S there. Just gonna put in a S with the teeth. Zero on the number pad to RAM preview.
Oh, hey, I'm Ross. I've just run out of ideas, so I'm going to make a fucking tutorial.
Usually, I find that when lip syncing, no matter how good you make it, it always seems to be one frame too late. So I usually highlight all the frames, Alt and left click, shift them all one frame to the left, and it all seems a little bit clearer.
Oh, hey, I'm Ross. I've just run out of ideas, so I'm going to make a fucking tutorial.
A background layer, new, solid, make it a nice color, maybe a pink, pull it to the bottom so that it is underneath the dinosaur, hit shift control forward slash, go into click lossless, and we're going to change this format to a QuickTime, quicktime.mov. Format options, and make it an H.264, 100%, okay. Audio output, you have to click this tick so that you have sound. Click OK, choose where it's going to land, choose desktop, dinosaur, save, hit enter or hit render, and it is rendering. Look at that speed. That is the sound of an orgasm. A computer orgasm. There you have it. You are now officially an animator with your own cartoon. Try out all these principles in your own character designs. I'm looking forward to making a few more of these tutorials. My next one is going to be animating this little bear. Let's call it character animation in After Effects. I've been Ross Plaskow. See you in the next lecture.